After discussing the mechanism and origin of Indian monsoon, now let us think over its impacts and its recent trends. Indian monsoon has some impact on Indian flood, drought, agriculture, and heavy rainfall in Thar desert, and the shifting of ice line over Himalayas. In the same way, Indian monsoon is characterized with some recent trends like somewhere cloudburst and somewhere drought, flood. So these are the latest phenomena which are taking place in India during recent years. That's why let us consider these points one by one, because these recent trends are the result of the nature and man-made cultural landscape changes in India. That's why there are questions in UPSC from these points. So these should be dealt with separately. Now let us discuss all those impacts one by one. First was flood, second was drought, and flood and drought affect Indian agriculture, industry, economy. So point number one is flood. What is flood? You know, it will be discussed later on also, but floods occur when the rain exceeds flow. And you have seen that the Bay of Bengal is more powerful and covers most of the country's land from eastern part. That's why the flood mostly occurs in the eastern part of India. It's what causes also the land of India slopes from northwest to southeast. That's why the rivers in Gangetic Plain drain from west to east, and here Brahmaputra, here Damodar, Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri. So along the eastern coastal plain and in the lower Gangetic Plain, there is flood. So you have to discuss the flood, its cause and impact. The second point will be drought. Drought is also explained by the failure of monsoon. Why monsoon is failed? And we have discussed that Indian monsoon is controlled by the topography of India. Regarding drought, we have to see that when the Arabian Sea branch comes and collides with the Western Ghat Mountain, so Western Ghat Mountain receives heavy rainfall, its western windward slope. But as these descend east, there is a rain shadow region. So this rain shadow region is a dry area, or droughts frequently occur in this belt. In the same way, when moisture laden wind collides with the Gir and Girnar mountains, the southern slopes receive heavy rainfall, but in north Rajkot, Surendranagar, there is dry area. And the area to the west of Harawali is also arid and semi-arid. So here to the east of Harawali, this is also semi-arid, because the Arabian branch through Mahi and Chambal directly reaches the plain. This way, here is one again dry area that spreads in a triangle that is formed by Ahmedabad, Kanpur and Jalandhar. This will be discussed later on in detail. So in India, these are the two dry areas or dry zone areas. Now, if this is flood prone area and people of eastern India is suffering from flood, natural calamity, at the same time the western India is suffering from drought. So east and west both India are suffering from this natural or climagenic calamities. It's one solution is also, now you can think over it, that we will be discussing in next chapters. Its solution is only to carry the flood water of East India to West. How? By interlinking the rivers and by extending the canal. And that will be called National Water Grid. So this is solution. Even then, the third point that is recent, that the impact of flood and drought over agriculture is very much serious. That's why it is sometimes said, and it is true also, in parliament it is a matter of debate, that Indian agriculture is gambled with Indian monsoon. Farmers, Indian farmers are gamblers, and they gamble with monsoon. Monsoon is uncertain and irregular. Uncertain means it should arrive here in Kerala on 1st of June, but sometimes it is late. Irregular means if onsets on 1st of June, then it should continue. But there are monsoon gaps. That's why, due to its erratic nature of uncertainty and irregularity, Indian farmers suffer, especially which crop? Rabi or Kharif. It is Kharif crop that depends on the monsoon. And that's why Indian agriculture is gambled with Indian monsoon. In the same way, sometimes it is said that Indian industry is also gambled with Indian monsoon. How? Agro-based industries depend on agricultural production, like jute industry, sugar industry, tea industry. And if the agriculture production will decrease due to failure of monsoon, then certainly in shortage of raw material, how agro-based industries may flourish. That's why it is said, questions are asked in UPSC that how Indian agriculture is gambled with Indian monsoon, how Indian industry is gambled with Indian monsoon, how Indian trade is gambled with Indian monsoon. Trade also, you can say, if there will be no agricultural production, no production from agro-based factories, then how trade will work? And transport is also gambled, because during severe floods, transport routes, rail routes, road routes are also damaged. That's why these are the gambles. Sometimes Indian politics is also gambled with Indian monsoon. Politicians promise that this year there will be good production and people will remain very good. And the agriculture products will be cheap. But it is in the hand of monsoon. If the cost of any agriculture product is increased due to its less production, then government fails and is being defeated. That's why overall Indian economy is gambled with Indian monsoon. That's why in parliament there is one session, monsoon session. Which monsoon session? That is summer monsoon session or winter monsoon session. In parliament there are three sessions. Which are those? Now it is a matter of study for you. But personally I feel that in geography it is summer season that affects Indian monsoon. And in summer season Indian monsoon affects Indian agriculture. And India is an agricultural country which affects Indian economy. That's why in summer drought and flood are matter of discussion in parliament. That's why if there is question that Indian economy is gambled with Indian monsoon, so you have to write, you have to focus especially on summer monsoon, failure of summer southwest monsoon. You should least discuss there about the winter monsoon, because Indian farmers don't depend on winter monsoon. They are ready for irrigation facilities for rabi crops. Next recent trend in Indian monsoon is that in the western Himalayas, there is the shift of ice line more than in eastern Himalayas. Why? This is also a point of discussion, that in the western Himalayas, in summer, ice line goes up. In winter, it comes down. Why? What is its reason? It is very obvious that it may be thar desert, that during summer, when sun is vertical over here, Cancer, then thar desert is heated excessively and convectional currents rise up. While rising, they spread. That's why, due to that warmth or heat, the Himalayan ice line goes up. But this is not case here in the eastern part of India or northeast. Why? There is no desert. Their convectional currents don't rise. But here in winter season, sun is in south hemisphere, and here it is very cool, and western disturbance are also coming down, and the cold Siberian air mass is also passing through the passes over greater Himalayas. That's why here its temperature is much less, below 0 degrees Celsius. That's why the ice line in the western Himalayas comes down. This is the reason that there is very much fluctuation in the ice line in western Himalayas, but at the same time less fluctuation in the eastern Himalayas. Why? One, here in eastern Himalayas, in the seven sisters and Assam state, there is no desert, no excessive heating, no excessive cooling. Why not excessive cooling? Because that is rich in biosphere or vegetation. Second point is that here, this eastern part of India or Himalayan region is closer to the sea. That's why here there is the marine impact of climatic conditions. Here is no continentality, but here in west part Rajasthan, there was continentality. One question there in far future may be that the ice line fluctuation now may be increasing in the eastern Himalaya. Why? It may be result of the politics here. If China will control the water of river Brahmaputra, then this Assam plain will become semi-arid. During that position, here temperature may rise, but nature is very much benign over here, because you have seen that here there is pre-monsoon rain. During May, there is flood in Assam Brahmaputra Valley. That is, here temperature will not be allowed to increase, and here there not be a desert like position. Next point, question may be that during recent years here in Rajasthan, the amount of rainfall is increasing. Previously it was much less. Why rainfall is increasing? Its credit may go to the Indira Canal. Here, from Satluj and Bias rivers, Indira Canal has been taken out, and up to Bikaner, and it has been extended more south. It irrigates a very widespread area, And second point, there is social forestry in Rajasthan, afforestation, reforestation. All these policies are making it green. And that's why the wind that is dry going from the Arabian branch receives some amount of moisture. Moisture from evaporation and evapotranspiration. That's why this moisture, while reaching north, condenses and precipitates in the form of rain. That's why UPSC may ask that during recent years, why the Rajasthan is receiving more flood and more rain. Next feature of Indian monsoon is there is maximum dew in the Seven Sisters or Northeast India. Why dew? Because there is dew point. There is saturation level. Why not in other parts? Because in other parts there is very high temperature range. But here in Northeast India temperature range is less. And for saturation level, condensation level, atmosphere requires high amount of vapor. And vapor is here from through two sources, evaporation and evapotranspiration. And here temperature is not allowed to increase because of nearness or proximity with the ocean. That's why the Northeast India receives high amount of dew, not so much amount in any part of the country. One recent trend is also that here it is West Bengal. In West Bengal, there is less rainfall, but very high flood. Why? Because of its geographical position. It is located here, which is being passed over by the monsoon, summer monsoon. And here is no topographic irregularity, no topographic variation, no mountain. That's why it receives less rain by either this Damodar branch or the monsoon coming from northeast. But why it records maximum flood, it is very much clear that this is a depression. This is a depression that will be discussed in tectonic. In this tectogenic depression, the water of Gangetic plain comes through it, and the water of this Assam carried by river Brahmaputra also drains through this. That's why West Bengal and Bangladesh receive less rain but witness very high flood. In the same way, in the characteristic or recent trend, we may study that in this Gangetic plain, most of the rain occurs in the month of July and August, but floods occur at the last of August or September. Why? It should also be discussed geographically. Actually, in the month of July, monsoon reaches here in Northwest India, but the July rain and up to mid-August, the rain amount is being evaporated because here temperature is very high, even July is very warm. That's why the rain water, most of it is being evaporated. But at the mid of August, the soil gets saturated, and after filtering down the water, when it is saturated, then it flows and drains into nala, rivulets and rivers. Then flood starts. That's why in Gangetic plain, although July and August receive maximum rain, but flood starts at the end of August and beginning of September. In the same way, there may be one question that in Rajasthan, recent years are witnessing flood. So Rajasthan is receiving high rainfall. The amount of rainfall has increased. But why flood? Because this is sandy desert. If sand water percolates or filters down, then there will no question of flood. But there is flood. Why? Because for its explanation, you have to see that this Rajasthan is geologically part of Indian Plateau. That is, hard rocks are there. Basal rocks are hard. Evidence is this Aravali Mountain. And there is weathered material, some 1 or 2 feet thick. Why weathering? Because when sun shines here, so it warms. During winter, when sun is in south hemisphere, it cools down. That's why high warming and high cooling causes thermal weathering. And that weathered sand is here. And that sand is saturated in a first shower of rainfall. And water is not allowed to filter down through the hard basal rocks. That's why floods occur here in Rajasthan. There is one phenomena that the Western Himalayas receive winter rain. What is its cause? We have discussed already that during winter season, when the sun is in south hemisphere over Capricorn, the convectional currents rise here, and in the form of westerly jet, they go and descend over here. During that time, the sun rays are slanting here. This area receives less insolation, and its temperature cools down due to cold Siberian wind. And that's why when western disturbance descend here, and they descend from at about 11 and 12 kilometer height, when they come down, their temperature increases and no chances of rainfall, and those become thirsty. But as they descend from over mountain top in the valleys, their thirst is being satisfied by evaporation and evapotranspiration, with the result when they go up on the next neighboring mountain, temperature decreases, condensation takes place. That's why during winter season, western part of India, Jammu Kashmir, receives rainfall. Next point, maybe question may be asked, what is air drainage? Air drainage means as water comes down from mountain top to hill slope, in the same way, this cool air from Himalayas descend to the Gangetic plain. This is called air drainage. When and why? During winter season. Why during winter season? Because during winters, the western Himalayas are too much cold, below 0 degrees Celsius. At the same time, this Gangetic plain records 20 plus Celsius. That's why there is thermal imbalance, then pressure gradient. To compensate this pressure gradient, the cool air blows from the western Himalayas to the Gangetic plain. This is air drainage, and this is the main feature of the winter season. There may be one question also, what is cloud burst and why and where does it occur in India? Cloud burst is a very simple thing that we have studied, that when on a mountain wind ascends from two opposite directions, this is mountain, one at which coming from this, one coming from this. With increasing height, their temperature decreases. As temperature decreases, relative humidity increases. When relative humidity received is 100%, sudden condensation starts and there is downpour. This is called cloudburst. Then this is the main feature of cloudburst. So, is there any mountain in India where from two opposite sides moisture, land and winds will collide? Yes, you know. Now you tell those positions. You start from here, this Anaimudi, and then here Dodabetta Nilgiri, Kudremukh, Mulangiri, here Mahabaleshwar, Kansubai. These are the mountain peaks which record that the Arabian branch and the Bay of Bengal branch reach here, collide, cause cloudburst. Then the line of cloudburst reaches to here Dhupgad, where this branch of Tapi and this branch of Godavari collide. Then that cloudburst line reaches Amarkantak. Then through over Vindhyachal, it goes to here Guru Shikhar, and then from over Aravali, it reaches to here Shimla. Previously, this Himachal Pradesh was noted for cloudburst. That was called locally Pangola. But it is again a new phenomena, new feature. Question may be that why the cloudburst incidents in western Himalayas are shifting from west to east. During recent years, 2013, 14 and 15, the cloudburst incidents are being witnessed in eastern part Chamoli, Pithoragarh, and previously their most frequency was in the western part of Himachal Pradesh. Why? Credit for this goes to who? Now it is very much clear that these days here the Arabian branch passing through the Thar Desert are more powerful. Why more powerful? Because they are getting moisture and energy released from the irrigated area of the Indira Canal. That's why they get more energy. In spite of colliding here in western part of Himachal Pradesh, now they move a little bit more and collide here in eastern part of Uttarakhand with Bay of Bengal branch. There may be one question that here you know that it is topic of Cancer, and if you calculate the area, in that computation you will see that most part of India lies to the north of this Cancer, that is in temperate, but its climate is called subtropical or tropical. Why? In this you have to focus on 2 points. Number one, on Himalayas. Number two, on cold Siberian air masses. On Himalayas, you have to write that during summer season, when southwest monsoon reaches India through two branches, that is Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal, this Himalayan range does not allow these branches to cross, and that Himalaya controls those winds and helps them cause total rainfall. After rainfall, their latent heat is also conserved over the Indian atmosphere. That's why India is tropical or subtropical. Now, second point, during winter season, when sun is in south hemisphere, again Himalayas have its role to play. During that season, from north, cold Siberian air masses try to approach Indian subcontinent, but fail. Why? This Himalayas also now stands and prohibits those cold Siberian air masses and protects India and keeps it relatively warm. That's why Himalaya has a special role to make to keep India warmer during summer and during winter. That's why if I have to explain why the most part of India lies in temperate but climate is tropical, you can explain it. Again, there is one point, that is the eastern coast of India receives more cyclones than the western coast. Why? And which cyclone? And why? Cyclone is temperate or tropical? Answer is obvious, clear. It is tropical cyclone. And why eastern coastal plain receives more cyclones? It is also clear. Because tropical cyclones developing in Bay of Bengal move on their axis in anticlockwise direction. But their nature to move on their orbit is from east to west. That's why these developing over Bay of Bengal move from east to west, better to say from southeast to northwest. That's why the eastern coastal plain of India frequently hit by tropical cyclones. Why not the western coastal plain? Because the tropical cyclones developing here move west. That's why it is safe and it is rarely hit by the tropical cyclones. But during these days, there is one trend that sometimes this Gujarat, sometimes this Mumbai coastal plains are hit by such cyclones. This is the recent trends or latest developments in the trend of tropical cyclones. Why during recent years the western coastal plain is hit by tropical cyclone? Now you think. Very simple to explain. These days, these years are witnessing here industrialization in western India, trade, transportation, industrialization, urbanization, deforestation. What impact these have? These will collectively increase the temperature of this region. When temperature will increase, pressure will decrease. When pressure will decrease, that low pressure area will invite the tropical cyclone of Arabian Sea. And that's why recent years are witnessing the impact of tropical cyclones on western coastal plain. One new question related to Indian monsoon is, artificial rain in India is possible or not? Yes, why not? Because for artificial rain, relative humidity at ground during evening should be more than 65%. In this condition, in cloud, there is cloud seeding of supercooled silver dioxide, which has two impacts. One, decreases temperature. Two, provides hygroscopic nuclei. That's why India has a very lengthy coastline, and there these conditions are found. That's why now Indian scientists, especially meteorologists, are thinking over it. And here in IMD Pune, there is cloud seeding technology. And that's why during recent years, in 1991, there was Project Raindrop in Gujarat, but it was failure. Why? Because that rain could not reach its target because of monsoon is uncertain and irregular. And second point, in monsoon climate, there are winds at different levels at different heights. Like at top, there is jet stream. Then below it, up to 2-3 km, there is anti-rate. Then monsoonal winds. Then land breeze, sea breeze. Thus, there are a number of circulation within circulation. That's why it was not targeted. But effort continued, and here in Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, and Karnataka, in 2003, 2004, 2014, 15, you will see those dates. And there it has proved successful. So artificial rain in India in along the coastal states is now successful. Related with Indian monsoon, there may be one question that why most of the rivers originating from Himalayas drain south, why not north towards China? Now its answer is very obvious that the southern slope of Himalayas receive more insolation and heat. Why? Sun never crosses Himalayas. Sun never goes to the north of Himalayas. Sun's maximum northern limit is Tropic of Cancer. That's why the southern slope receive more insolation and there is high temperature. And that's why the melting of glaciers is much along the southern slope and rivers flow and originate southward. But in the northern slope of the Himalaya, insolation is less, that is ice covered, and their glaciers don't melt. That's why rivers don't rise and flow in north. Related with this, there may be one more question that the southern slope of Himalayas has a rich biosphere. Why rich biosphere? Why northern slopes don't have? Southern slopes are rich in biosphere means there is variety of plants and animals. Why? To discuss the plant variety, we have to consider mainly 2 points. One, high temperature. The southern slopes have high temperature, but not northern. High temperature is needed for the germination of seeds and growth of plant. And the second point is the southern slope receive more summer rain by southwest monsoon. Thus, the water is also supplied to plant. Third point you can add that the southern slopes of Himalayas have good soil. Good means in comparison to northern slope. Here, soil has some humus, some thickness. That's why the southern slopes have a rich and variety of plants. And where there is good plant kingdom, animal kingdom will be good. That's why the southern slope of Himalayas have rich biosphere in comparison to another. Sometimes there may be one question that the climate of India is now monsoon, but what is its paleoclimate? Paleoclimate means past climate. For it, you have to study the geophysics of India or Indian plate. Today, India is here having monsoon type of climate. But before it, it was on equator. There was equatorial climate. Before that, it was in south temperate. There was temperate climate. Before that, it was physically attached with Madagascar and South Africa. So, climate was a little bit cooler. And before that, attached with Africa, it was on the South Pole. So, climate was here, frigid. It shows that the paleoclimate of India started from frigid, polar. And now, as India moved north, for some time with Africa and after the separation of Africa, it came in physical contact with Asia. So climate is here. This you will write in paleoclimate. Now its future climate is that we will be discussing in the neotectonic of Indian plate, means India is moving northeastward, and it along with China may again touch North Pole, and the climate of India may again change. In India, there are two semi-arid regions. Arid region is one in Rajasthan to the west of Aravali. But semi-arid regions are two. One to the east of Aravali in Rajasthan. And the second is here, this rain shadow region situated to the east of West Ghat Mountain. Which one is better these days? Now you have to give its answer. Actually, the semi-arid area in Kerala, Karnataka and Maharashtra is better, has better prospects. Why? Because there is some amount of rainfall, about 40 to 80 centimeter annual, which causes rain there. The Arabian branch passing through wind gaps. And second point is here there is some vegetation, and in that vegetation some spices and coffee, cashew, all these things are produced there. That's why this is better. And packing industry and other forest based industries are also found here. That's why this south semi-arid area is richer in resource view and human view in comparison to the semi-arid area to the east of Aravali. What are the drawbacks in Aravali? Here there is less rain and the land is ravinous. Who has made it ravinous? A number of rivers led by the Chambal. And that's why people here are also not developed. This is the reason that the southern semi-arid area is richer and has more prospect than the semi-arid region in Rajasthan. One recent trend in Indian climatology is that there is development of micro-urban climate. You have studied what is urban climate. The special features of climate over cities like heat island, pollution dome, plume, urban wind cell. And as we have seen that the post-independence period in India has witnessed rapid urbanization in India. Mega and metro cities are coming into existence. That's why over them the microclimate is changing rapidly. And where this urban climate will be found, it is easy for you to locate on map. Mega cities like Kolkata, Mumbai, Delhi, Chennai, Mangalore, likewise. So this with the map, with the help of map, you can write what is the causes of change in these cities. And in turn, the micro-urban climate is affecting the regional climate or the monsoon of India. One more question is there. What is the difference between weather map and climate map of India? Actually, climate map of India has been prepared by Köppen, Thanthwaite, R.L. Singh, a number of geographers. And climate map shows different regions based on temperature, humidity, and vegetation. But these weather maps, you might have seen, weather maps are different, and weather maps are issued after every 24 hours. In 24 hours, weather conditions, that is temperature, pressure, wind, relative humidity, are changed. That's why you might have seen on news, TV screen, newspapers, magazines, the weather map. There it is shown, and temperature is written, pressure is shown with the help of isobars, rain amount, and the status of cloudiness, wind direction, all these things are written there. That's why it is easy to differentiate between the weather map of India and climate map of India.